Well, hi there, guys and gals. So what have we got here? This is the external microphone for the Akaso Brave 6 Plus, which I actually had to order from the USA Amazon because not yet in stock in the UK. It turned up quickly enough anyway, no problem. Easy enough to use. It's just a question of plugging it into the USB-C socket in the camera, like so. And as you can see, it's got a little clip on it so that you can clip it on to your front of your sweatshirt or whatever, by your chin somewhere. Or in my case, as you'll see in my picture here, for my motorcycle vlogging, I clipped it on just onto the foam just inside the helmet. It's got very long lead on it. It must be at least a meter. One problem you will have, of course, using an action camera on a motorcycle is you can't actually plug in an external mic while it's in the waterproof case. I have had some success modifying a case by burning a little hole in the side, quite easy, and you then of course you can plug in. You could always seal it with a bit of rubber or silicone or something. But for this test, I in fact used an open frame, which of course is okay as long as it's not raining. Anyway, sound quality was good. I've got visor up, visor down. It's a full face helmet, but it's a flip up, so you do get a lot of wind noise anyway. But I thought the quality was very good. Did the job and worth the money. Now, you may have noticed there's something stuck on the front of this Brave 6 Plus. That's my little furry windshield that I put on. I did actually use it paragliding the other day, and it was quite effective in cutting down wind noise because the microphone hole's just back there. Look at that valley. I'm testing because I've put a little windshield on the front of this. I'm hoping it'll cut down wind noise. So with a bit of luck, you'll hear what I'm saying without too much wind noise. Anyway, that's enough of my homemade windshield. This is me doing some motorcycle vlogging with the Akaso external mic. And as you can see, I've actually included some video from the first lockdown and the second lockdown as a comparison. And you can see quite clearly people aren't actually taking the second one very seriously. Anyway, here are the clips. I've come down to the local tourist town because in the first lockdown I made a video of it and it was ghostly quiet. I'm curious to see in this second lockdown that we've got whether it's just as quiet. So I'll give you a quick comparison of before and after. Oh, right. Well, I can clearly see. I'll show you. This is apparently lockdown number two. Look how many people are around. And now here's a clip of what it looked like in lockdown number one. In lockdown number one, everybody was staying at home. They're certainly not staying at home now. And this incidentally is Torquay in Torbay, which has got one of the highest rates of COVID in the area, certainly in the local area, Devon. So I'm just going to cruise down to the seafront now. I'll see you in a bit. Anyway, we're coming down to Torquay seafront. This is visor up, by the way. Now this is the little line of bars and things that on Torquay seafront. Obviously doing some takeaways now because I'll just show you what it's like now. Lockdown number two. And coming up, here's a clip of lockdown number one. And as you can see, there were no people there then. Right. Okay, so all I've done with this external mic is I've got it plugged in, the camera. I'm using an open frame because one problem you get with any external mic, if you want to use it with the waterproof cases, you can't plug it in while the waterproof case is on. So I've got it in an open frame. In fact, I've got it in a backpack clip type thing and on a mount that's just on a tripod screw. Right, I'm just going to go around the harbour here. Check out what this is like now.
Right, well, it is November, but there are still quite a few people around compared to the first lockdown, March, April, which again wasn't exactly tourist season. So I'll just show you a quick clip of what it was like here. Fucking wanker. Jesus Christ, eh? Even the bus driver gave me a look of what was the guy doing going straight across in front of me. So desperate to find somewhere to parking. Anyway, a lot of people are into this vlogging stuff now where you're giving a commentary as you're riding. I must say, I'm more used to speaking to a camera where I can edit and do two or three takes. So this is a new discipline for me, trying to talk and get it right first time. So this is just around kind of little shopping mall arcade before and after. And down by the seafront we're coming up to. So, still quite a few people around. I'll show you what it was like in March. I think people are lockdown weary. Put the visor down again. I'll put it halfway down. So probably compromise there between not quite so echoey, and now there's very little wind on the foam guard on the mic. But I'm interested to see myself. This is the absolute first time I've tested this. And what I'm hoping to do is try paragliding, because when I'm up in the air with a helmet on, without a visor, I do get quite a bit of wind noise from action cameras. And this Brave 6 Plus in 4K with EIS. Oh, look at the number of people around here. Yeah, what lockdown, what lockdown? Look at the number of cars. You'd never believe there was a lockdown on. We're locked down for a month now. Quite a lot of cars along there for November. But of course, this is lockdown number two, so I don't think people are taking it so seriously. And we're continuing here with the Acasso Brave 6 Plus in 4K with gyro stabilisation on, which has become my favourite action camera out of the many dozens that I've tested. You don't get many budget action cameras with 4K with EIS. Admittedly, only 30 frames a second. And as I say, we're testing the external mic. This is with the visor down, so it probably sounds a bit boomy. This is with the visor up. Well, that's better. It's quite a windy day, so I don't know how much wind noise there is. And with a flip-up helmet, you do get quite a lot of more noise. I did say that before. But we're coming up to kind of shopping area in Paignton. I'd imagine there's a few people around there. I don't know if you can see it there. Quite a lot in the main shopping precinct, if you can see up there. Anyway, I'll just break the video here.
And then we're going to try it on the dual carriageway with a bit of speed.
And here's on the dual carriageway with a bit more speed. And of course, sod's law, I've got a police car in front of me. But it is a de-restricted road, which means I can go fast on it. Probably fast enough to actually swing the camera around. That's what usually happens. It's in an open mount, so I've no doubt at speed. This is... I've got to flip my visor up a little bit here. This is 60 miles an hour. Probably quite noisy. I've got to flip the visor up because it's steaming up. Right, this is visor down, 60 miles an hour. And I've no doubt the camera's probably swung around with the wind force on it. But I mean, I've actually, because it's a flip-up helmet, I do get quite a lot of wind noise in it anyway. Because it's got joins around the side where it flips up. anyhow, that's the end of this. If you have found it useful, why not check out my channel? There's loads of action camera tests if you're into that. There's sailing, there's loads of paragliding, paramotoring, wildlife and drones and well, you name it. I'd be surprised if there's something there that doesn't catch your eye. But that's it for now. I'll catch you again soon. Take care, stay safe and social distance and all that stuff. Bye for now.